إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد إخوتي في الله فاعلموا أن خير الكلام كلام الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار ثم أما بعد إخوتي في الله We will go بإذنه سبحانه وتعالى over تفسير سورة الحجرات. This short surah contains many lessons for Muslims and for non-Muslims as well. And this is one of the treasures of Islam that we need to share with non-Muslims instead of trying to follow their footsteps. Instead of trying to catch up with them, if we can only share this ni'mah, these blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we have, I think it would be sufficient. Surah Al-Hujurat, ya ikhwati fillah, is a surah that every Muslim should recite, should read, and should memorize. Because in our daily dealings, this surah is essential, it's important, it's must. A lot of times, we try to justify things, assume things, try to read the facial expression of individuals, try to read between the lines of the statement that has been said to us. And if we only read, understand, and learn the meaning of this surah, it would be better for Muslims in general. لِأَنَّ اللَّهَ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى revealed the Qur'an for us to reflect and ponder over it. Allah يقول, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ أَمْ عَلَى قُلُوبٍ أَقْفَالُهَا أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ A question that Allah asks subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't they reflect upon the Qur'an? Or they just read the Qur'an? See, there's a difference between reading the Qur'an or even reciting the Qur'an and a tadabbur, which means you reflect on each ayah. When you recite Alif, Lam, Mim, ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه. You try to reflect on that ayah. What is the meaning of first ayah Alif Lam Mim? Does it have a meaning? What did the ulama say about this? And then you say ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه. What a wonderful kitab. What a wonderful book. This is called reflection. You're reflecting on the Quran. A lot of Muslims, you see them, وَلِلَّهِ الْحَمْدُ, sitting in the house of Allah, وَكَفَى بِهَا نِعْمَةً. And they read the book of Allah and it's extra ni'mah. But they read the Quran because they were told that they have to finish the Quran by the end of the month of Ramadan. Therefore, they try to read that juz, that chapters that is left for them to finish. And then they just read without trying to understand the message of Quran and what Allah is trying to say to us when Allah is talking to us through the Quran. لذلك إخوتي في الله, in this, we will reflect over Surah Al-Hujurat. Tafsir is different thing, different level. Kalima, kalima, حرف, حرف. But we will go over this as reflections بإذنه سبحانه وتعالى. But it's also important to have background about the surah itself. This surah, Ya Ikhwati Fillah, as you know, is known, has been named Surah Al-Hujurat. Wal-Hujurat is a plural of Hujrah, means room, means غرفة or apartment, and this pertaining to the rooms of the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, because the Messenger of Allah, يا إخوتي في الله, never lived in a house that has 5 bedrooms, 2 living rooms, 6 bathrooms. He never lived in a house that is more than what he would need. When Aisha radiyallahu anha was describing the size of his room, imagine this is the house of the Messenger of Allah. She said radiyallahu anha, when Rasulullah is praying Qiyam al-Layl, when he's praying Qiyam al-Layl, and he's standing during the night in the middle of the night, I would extend my feet in front of him. And when he wants to make sujood, he would tap me. And I would gather myself, I would put my feet back, so he can make sujood. يعني his room, his house, was not enough more than 2 people. And Aisha had to gather herself so he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam may be able to make sujood. So hujr or hujrah means room. Wa hujurat is a plural of this. Wa yaqul Ibn Hajr al-Asqalani fi Fath al-Bari, and these rooms that has been mentioned are pertaining to the rooms of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And these rooms are the rooms who a wafd from Bani Tamim, a delegation from Bani Tamim, came to the masjid or came to the city of Medina. And then they couldn't find the Messenger of Allah in the masjid. So they went to the hujr or hujurat Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they yelled and screamed, raising their voices outside the house of the Messenger of Allah, demanding and requesting, as a matter of fact, demanding the Messenger of Allah to come to them. And we will come to that bi idnihi subhanahu wa ta'ala. This surah, ya ikhwati fillah, has been understood also is Surah Madaniyah, meaning the surah was revealed in the city of Medina. Wa Imam al-Qurtubi rahimahullah qala hadha ijma', he said this is what the ulama of Ahl al-Sunnah wal Jama'ah agreed upon, that this surah was revealed in the city of Medina. And by the methodology and the way that the surah is being organized and the ayat and the verse being placed, it is very obvious for Muslims to understand this is surah Madaniyah. Because most of the surah is dealing with the issue of akhlaq, manners, and ahkam, detailed ahkam. And this was only in the city of Medina, not in Mecca. The ayat of this surah, Ya Ikhwati Fillah, are 18. And this is number 49 surah in the book of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. This surah was revealed right after Surah Al-Mujadala. قَدْ سَمِعَ اللَّهُ قَوْلَ الَّتِي تُجَادِلُكَ فِي زَوْجِهَا. After that surah, Surah Al-Hujurat was revealed. Surah Al-Hujurat was revealed. But you can see at the same time, one side, if you go towards Surah Al-Nas, you will see Mujadala Surah Hashr. And if you go towards the Fatiha, you will see Mujadala Thumma Surah Al-Hadid. And Surah Al-Hujurat is not in order, in a sense that you have Surah Al-Hujurat Thumma Surah Al-Mujadala. But in terms of revelation, this surah was revealed right after Surah Al-Mujadala. يقول بعض العلماء عدد كلماتها 353 words. The kalimat of this surah is 343 words. 353. Also, Ya Ikhwati Fillah, one thing that is very unique about this surah started with addressing the believers. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu. So from the beginning you would see and you will realize, Allahu Akbar, this surah is for me. This surah is not something that is for the kuffar to come and accept this beautiful religion. This surah is not for the asi, that hardly the trace of iman left is still left in his heart. But this is for the true believers. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, O you who believe. From that you would understand that this surah was revealed for a person who is willing to learn, willing to understand, willing to implement what he or she learned and understood from the book or from this surah. لأن الله يقول فذكر فإن الذكرى تنفع المؤمنين. And Allah يقول يا أيها الذين آمنوا. Allah said, remind, indeed reminding would benefit the believers. And here Allah is saying, oh who you believe. So Allah addressing the believers in particular. In this, Ya Ikhwati Fillah, this surah was known amongst the ulama of tafsir, Surah Al-Akhlaq. The other name of this surah was Surah Al-Akhlaq, chapter of manners, chapter of behavior, chapter of good conduct, Surah Al-Akhlaq. This surah will shape you, will fashion you, will give you a better direction towards perfection. This surah will allow you to become a better person, person who is conscious of what he will say or do. This surah would allow you to be a person who always holds himself or herself in account. And say, why did you say that, Ya Akhi? Or say to yourself, why did I say this? Why did I do this? Because it's Surah Al-Akhlaq, Ya Ikhwati Fillah. This akhlaq that is needed nowadays. See, this kuffar, subhanAllah, they're still working. And I should not say the kuffar, but mankind in general. They still struggling. That aiming for that perfection, good manners, good behavior. And every day you see new rules, new regulations. Oh, there's an organization called for human rights. They fight for human rights. How humans should be dealt with. And the one that is dealing with a human is a human himself. And the one who's making the rules is a human himself. And if they only, they say, if they only say, SubhanAllah, let us see and examine this book. That they will make their job very easy. No matter what they do, no matter what they come up nowadays, they will always come back to the laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, it is in our ikhwati fil, our responsibility to teach the people manners, behaviors, to live and how to live as a Muslim. This surah, ya ikhwati fillah, deals with sharia, the laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and how can that sharia be implemented in our daily lives. This surah also is dealing with how a Muslim should live with non-Muslims. Nowadays, walillahi alhamd, we have golden opportunity to show the beauty of Islam. To show what Islam is made of. To show to these non-Muslims that are watching you every single movement that you make, every single action that you take, they are watching you. They don't watch the rest of people. They don't watch what they do, but they're watching you because you claim perfection. You say, I follow Islam. So they don't see what Islam said about how women should be treated. And only was only early 19th century that women in the West were allowed to be called human. It was a long time ago. In France, 1904, 1914, women were given the authority to own properties. And Fatima bint Muhammad and Asma bint Abi Bakr, they were the owners of properties. Islam gave them that from the first day. But now they say, oh look, this deen, this religion abuses women. And if you ask them a simple question, if this religion abuses women, why 70% of new Muslims are women? It does not make any sense. Oh, we abuse women. However, the majority of the reverts are Muslim. Imagine these women who were read, oh, this religion abused women. I like to be abused. Please sign me up as a member. I like to be abused. It does not make any sense. However, they're quick to claim and label that we abuse women. This is a golden opportunity for a Muslim to say, look, look. Wallahi, a brother of mine, a friend of mine, a Saudi brother, jazakallah khair, in a marketplace with his wife wearing a niqab. He is a doctor. He came to study medicine. He finished school. His wife is well educated. He authored books, walillahi alhamd, about behaviors, NLPs. He knows what he's talking about. And while they were making shopping, this Catholic lady carefully start walking behind them, tiptoeing, making sure that he's not looking.